He told you you're not good enough. When he told you you're not right. When he told you you're not strong.
You guys know this song? It's one of my all-time favorites.
Put up a good fight. When he told you you're not worthy.
Good morning.
He told you you're not loved.
This is a song I probably listen to every time I smile. Curious if you guys have ever seen this song.
Never be enough.
All right. Well, good morning. That was Fear is a Liar by Zach Williams. It's one of my all-time favorite songs. This, I'd probably say like the last 2 years. I don't know when it came out, but I know that I haven't flown, right? Like this whole 2020 since last February. But prior to that, anytime I fly, this is a song that I always listen to because Fear is a Liar, right? So this morning I am coming on here. I am a day before my third round of chemo. Tomorrow is my third round of chemo. And I've had a lot of people ask, like, how are you feeling? Does that make you nervous? Does that make you anxious? Are you, you know, excited to just get this over with? And so I thought I would share because I know we all have different anxieties over different things. I know that for me, flying, for some reason over the last couple of years, I had a really rough flight home once from Utah a couple years ago. And ever since, I cannot even explain it or control it, but I get this horrible, tensed up stomach, have to go to the bathroom, which is like the worst thing to happen on an airplane, right? And this overwhelming, like, feeling that I just can't control. And so I've learned how to control it, how to ease it, and all these different things over the last couple of years, which again is just a gift because here I am going through chemo. And yes, I do feel a little anxious the day before. I feel anxious to get through this, but most of all, it's the needles. I don't love needles. And so they have to first take your blood, which means they have to find a vein first, which is not easy on me. Then second, they have to, after they get the blood work back and everything looks good, then we start chemo. So then they have to poke me with a different needle to get that in. And there's just something weird about me and needles and any of those things. So like while I'm sitting there for 6 hours and they're giving me chemo, anytime I look at the needle, I get like this tingly lightheadedness. Like it's just something that does bother me. And so I have learned over the years, like when there's different things like that, how to ease my anxiousness. So I know we all have anxiousness over different things, right? It might be holiday season. It might be being around certain family members. It might be to do with money. It might be to do with getting out. It might be to do with this coronavirus right now. I'm like, what do I do? How do I handle all of this? And I totally understand. And I thought that these things that I've been doing might help some others. So if you know anybody who gets anxious or feels anxiety, please forward this on to them. Hit the share button, hit the watch party button. And I'm excited to share with you guys today my top 5 tips to helping yourself when you're starting to feel anxiety or you're going into something that you know normally causes you that anxious feeling. So my name is Blair Critch. If somebody did hit the share button or the watch party button and you're seeing me for the first time, I live in South Florida. I have 2 teenage boys. I'm currently getting myself healthy and rid of cancer, but I currently am going through chemo. This is my real hair, but on a wig because I'm actually bald right now. And this is a really cool wig that I had made out of my own hair before it fell out. And I'm excited to share this with you today. So here's my 5 top tips. I don't see anybody on here, so let me make sure it's not set up for private, which it is. This keeps happening on Facebook. So sorry about that if you're just hopping on. You're going to have to go back and watch from the beginning because for some weird reason, it was set to private and not to public. So sorry about that. All right, here's my 5 tips for helping you when you start to feel anxiety coming on or you know you're about to go into a situation that normally gives you anxiety, okay? So tip number 1, exercise. Do not underestimate the power of endorphins, okay? They always push you to feel your best. It's why literally as I was getting out of the hospital from my hysterectomy, they said, get up and start walking. Everyone I talked to post-op was like, get up and start walking. Everyone that I've talked to that's been through chemo is like, try to exercise, right? So whatever that is for you, exercising, do not underestimate it. It is so important. And especially the week before, the days before, something that you know normally would give you some kind of anxiety or anxiousness, it's important. Even so much as the days that I used to travel for work and I did not love the airplane ride, if I could get up that morning and do a little exercise before I left for the airport, even better, right? Because we know those endorphins, they're going through your body, they're helping you, and that can just be a walk. It doesn't have to be, a 30-minute hardcore Peloton ride. It could be a gentle walk as long as you're getting those endorphins moving, okay? Getting active and getting that exercise on. The second thing, hi Jennifer, so good to see you, Jen. The second thing that I have found that really helps me, and as I'm getting ready for chemo tomorrow, I try to make sure I'm not journaling every single day right now. I'm just being honest, but I am definitely like, a couple days before something's about to happen, an appointment, anything like that, I'm always making sure I'm journaling. So journaling is my second one. Writing it down and then moving on. So it's okay to feel anxious, to feel sad, to feel frustrated, to feel mad. Like emotions are okay. I don't know why we always are trying to suppress them. I'm one of those people. I hate feeling those feelings. But the reality is, you've got to feel them in order to move on. If you just keep suppressing them and shoving them underneath the bed, for example, eventually they'll just explode and come out. So instead, write it down in your journal, then move on. After you write something negative, try to turn it into a positive. So sometimes what I'll do is I'll start with one page in my journal and I'll just write everything, like how I'm feeling, what I'm mad about, what I'm anxious about, what I'm frustrated about. And then on the other side, I'll change them into positive statements. Like, I am so thankful that I am strong enough to get through this. I am so thankful that my veins are going to be easy for these nurses to find on Friday for my chemo treatment. Like all these different things, you can take all those negatives and turn them into a positive, say them over yourself, and then be done, right? So I'm curious if you guys use journaling to help you get through those times when you're feeling anxious or upset or have things going on. So I really believe journaling is a big one. So far it's exercise, journaling, and number three is be careful what you fill your head with. If you have listened to any of my lives before, you know I'm a really big one on this. It's like, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. It's so true. So be careful what music you're listening to. Be careful what shows you're allowing into your head, right? If you're already having some conflicts with people, I would say this. If I'm a huge Real Housewives fan, any of you guys who know me know it's like my guilty pleasure. But if you're going through any kind of relationship problems, or you're having issues with family or issues with friends, I would not watch a show like that where people are literally fighting all the time. I would not watch a show like that because it just revs up and makes you think more about something, right? Instead, you should be filling your head with positive things. Same thing with music. I'm really careful, for example, when I'm flying. I know I get anxious when I fly. So I have a whole playlist that is literally just for flights. It is all the happy, upbeat songs that I like. It is lots of praise music, lots of classical music, the things that will make me be praise music, the things that will put me in the right mindset. One of my sweet friends, Terry Carey, huge shout out to you. She made me this beautiful playlist of like my all-time favorite songs, which a lot of them were already on my airplane playlist. And she made me this beautiful playlist that's called The Blair Project, that goes along with that time at 11:11 when people stop and pray for me, which is so amazing. But I'm using that playlist right now for the whole week before chemo. I listen to it every morning. I try to listen to it anytime I have free time during the day. I listen to it while I'm at chemo. That is just something that really fills my head with the right things. So be careful what you listen to, be careful what you look at, because that all those things will either play into your anxiety or help ease you out of your anxiety, okay? Tip number four, do something for you. All right, especially mamas. I'm talking to you right now because we are always putting everybody else first during the holiday season, especially during this COVID time. We're probably out trying to help our neighbors. We're out trying to help our friends. We're out trying to help our parents. We're out trying to help our in-laws. We're trying to help our family. We're doing everything for everybody. But you need to do something for you. So, what is something that you love to do? Is it yoga? Is it taking a walk on the beach? Is it going for a hike? Is it taking a bath? Is it having dinner on the beach? Is it Is it going out with some girlfriends? Now, I want to be really specific about this. When you're doing something for you, especially before something that's going to be maybe a little bit more stressful time, or you know and feel your anxiety coming on, or you're already there, I'm not talking about going out for a girls' night and hitting up the town and having a ton of drinks where you're going to feel like crap the next morning, and that's actually going to make your anxiety feel worse because alcohol plays into anxiety, fear, and all those things, okay? Because it does something to us inside. I can guarantee you, any woman in her 40s can tell you that a lot of times you feel more anxious the day after you drink, right? And that's because of all the stuff going on inside of our body. So when I say do something you love to do, you might also need to be careful about what that is. So for me, I do love a girls' night. A girls' night fills my cup. But if I have more than two drinks at girls' night, then the next morning I feel like crap. Then that just like adds on to my anxiety and to my pressure and all the things that I need to do, right? So if for me, if I decide that a girls' night is going to be my thing to do, I'm going to make sure there's things wrapped around that, right? There's boundaries wrapped around that. So it might be I plan the girls' night and I say to my friends, hey, let's meet at the beach and I'll bring, so I live in Fort Lauderdale. Let's all bring a beach chair. Let's meet at the beach and bring your own drink and let's just sit on the beach and talk and catch up. That fills my cup because it's a relaxing, chill night. I don't have to get all dressed up. We're not going to be going from bar to bar drinking a ton. People might have one or two drinks, but I can bring just one or I can have none. And it doesn't matter because we're sitting at the beach, we're just chatting, catching up, and filling up our cup, right? Another thing for me is, for example, tomorrow is chemo. So I have things set up today. This morning, I went for a long, beautiful walk. I have work stuff that I'm doing, but I've also set time throughout the day today to do things for myself, like my meditation. I set up a time today to go get a facial. You know, those are the kind of things that you need to make sure you're doing. I also have a massage set every single week while I'm going through chemo right now because that's something that like eases my mind and helps my body. And those are things that are important to me. So think about something that you love to do and making sure that you make time for it. Hi guys, I see you hopping on. All right, my tip number five, my last and final tip for when you're feeling anxiety coming on or you're already feeling anxiety is go to bed with gratitudes on your mind. Your subconscious is so powerful. So I want you to go to bed doing two things. One, stating your gratitudes from the day. I say a minimum of five, up to 10 would be better. Okay. So you're literally saying those to yourself as you're going to bed. And the second thing that is so huge for yourself as you're going to sleep at night is listening to a meditation. Okay. It's so important that we listen to meditation as you're going to sleep at night, if at all possible. You can find Christian meditations. You can find music meditations. You can find sound wave meditations. You can find where somebody leads you through the meditation, right? So there are meditations on YouTube for free for all those categories. There are meditations for free on YouTube that are for people that feel anxious or for people who need to sleep deeper, all these different things. So if you can go to bed listening to one of those meditations, that's going to be a helpful thing for you as well. And also going to bed with the gratitudes because your subconscious is so powerful. And when you're thinking about something as you go to sleep, it will continue to think over that throughout the evening. It's why it's so important, again, like I said in tip number three, to be careful what you fill your head with. Because if you're going to bed at night, and you just watch some kind of really horrible show, then that's all going to be inside your subconscious as you're going to sleep. Okay? So I hope that these five tips are helpful today. I'd love to know from you, what do you do? Like when you start to feel anxious, what do you do? When you start to feel anxiety coming on, or you already know like this certain thing always brings me anxiety. Like I know that going into chemo, it's the, you know, my veins and them trying to find a vein to put the needle in. That's going to cause me anxiety. So I already have things that I'm preparing and doing to help me with that. Or maybe for you, it's flying or traveling or family or money or whatever. So drop below, what do you do to ease yourself during these times, right? I love it. Rebecca said, gratitude before you go to bed and when you wake up. Amen. So true. Dara, I love meditation. I love using it as I am like literally I listen to it as I'm going through whatever it is that I'm going through. And they're so powerful. I love them. Yes, I always talk to God too when I am anxious. That's 100%, 100%. When I'm writing in my journal, it's literally like I'm writing to God. And when I'm praying, I'm talking to God, right? We have that personal relationship with Him. So absolutely, that's a great tip too. Going into Walmart gives me anxiety. So I try to make a plan, so smart. Or The great thing, Dara, is Walmart has pickup, right? So if going into Walmart gives you anxiety, you could place your order online and then pick up, right? Like, don't you just drive there and they put it right in your trunk? So that's always a great way to ease your anxiety too. All right, guys, I hope you have a great day and make it a great day for others. And if you found these 5 tips helpful, hit the share button or hit the watch party button and let's help other people. Because you know what, this time of year, people have a lot of anxiousness around them. There's a lot going on. And we add on top of that the coronavirus and all those things going on in the economy. And you know, I really just hope that everybody can see that there is so much light in this world and that we can look for that light. That is exactly what God wants us to do each and every day. So have a great day. Make it a great day for others. Bye.